study first topic for the session. In the first topic for the session, we'll be seeing various theories of capital structure. Now, various people have come with various viewpoints. Should debentures be there or not in a capital structure? We know one thing for sure, that debentures is that which increases the value of the equity shareholders. For a small illustration, you saw when you have more debentures, it increases the value of the equity. So, value of the firm is increased when you have more debentures. We can say debentures meets the objective of finance. Second, cost of debentures is always less than cost of equity. So, when I talk about the another objective of optimum capital structure, that is the cost of capital should be minimized, and you work out in this objective. So, two objectives of capital structure are met actually when you have debentures and capital structure. But debenture increases your risk as well. More debentures means more leverage or more risk. So, various people have come with various viewpoints. Are capital structure decisions relevant or not? Based on this, we have various theories of capital structure. We have modern theories and we have traditional theories. So, we'll be covering capital structure theories under two heads, modern approach and traditional approach. Under modern approach, we'll be covering three theories, net income approach, net operating income approach, and Modigliani and Miller approach. At the end of the theories, you decide what you feel. Should debentures be there or should debentures be not there? See, one thing keep in mind, that debentures actually increases your liability, it increases your risk or leverage from the long-term point of view. The most classic example I can give is what happened to Sahara Group when Roy landed up in prison in 2014. The case is still not sorted out because of SEBI guidelines. Unless the debentures are paid off along with interest, the court won't release him. If you see, from 1 year onwards, the company is selling a property, fixed assets all over the world, is still not able to meet the COPA demand of interest and the principal payment. So it increases their interest. And who will bear the cost now? Equity shareholders will pay. At that point of time, if you see, return of the equity goes down. So if you see, equity shareholders actually suffer when you have to pay debentures, because who will pay from their pocket? Equity shareholders will only pay from their pocket to pay the debenture holders, because they are the real owners of the company. And if you see, value of equity goes down then. So what do we do now? Right? So these are various theories which are developed from time to time, and they focus on the same. One thing keep in mind, the two objectives of capital structure. One thing is that the cost of capital should be minimized and the value of the firm should be increased. And there's a relationship among all the three things. There's a relationship among capital structure, cost of capital, and the value of the firm. The aim of effective capital structure is to maintain that the value of the firm is increased and your cost of capital is decreased. Now, similarly, capital structures are very, very important financial decision. You've seen the four important decisions in finance. We have financing decision, investment, distribution, dividend. And in financing decision, we see how a company gets money. You saw cost of capital in unit one. Now we're starting with capital structure. You'll also see the risk part, that is leverage, in the other sessions. Three things are important in a financing decision: cost of capital, capital structure, and leverage. Cost of capital was the minimum return you need to give to an investor. Capital structure is all about the relationship among the various sources of finance. And this capital structure is a very, very important financial decision, because it affects the value of the firm. It also leads to the change in EBIT and the market value of share. That's why capital structure decision is important. But various people came with various viewpoints. Let us see what they have to say. Is capital structure decisions relevant or irrelevant?